Hello. It looks that we had another day full of interesting events. First, I need to mention another density spike, which appeared on not so long ago on ACE readings. Density reached 100 units for a second time in last 2 days. By coincidence, both versions of SWMF magnetosphere cuts show right now the impact of this wave. However, notice that there is more than half hour of difference between those readings. I have no idea which readings are more accurate. There wasn't any geomagnetic storm connected with this spike, but on ACE Mach graph we can see that the phi angle shifted visibly in the first half of June 25th. This means that Earth entered a part of IMF with different direction of current flow. This means that Earth entered a part of IMF with different direction of current flow. And when we look at the Enlil readings, we will see that indeed a sector boundary crossed magnetosphere somewhere at this time. Thanks to Timur Petrenko, who sent me link to this monitor, which shows the Schumann resonance measurements, I can show you some very disturbing impulse, which took place in the evening of June 26th and peaked at 15 to 17 UTC. Schumann resonance is sometimes called the pulse of Earth, as it is the frequency of interactions between the ionosphere and surface of our planet. Read it by yourselves. Whatever caused this pulse, it was quite powerful. Notice that on previous day, some smaller disturbances took place in the same hours. With a tiny difference. I've checked some ionospheric monitors and it looks that at the time of this energy burst, there was a strong flux of energetic particles via the equatorial connectivity. But those anomalies are visible here almost every day, however not that strong. Another factor is visible on the HMF2 monitor, where the main flux tube connection moved back to the Western Pacific region, where it visibly liked to be most of the time. At the time when the impulse took place, the height of connection point dropped from 520 to 440 kilometers. Notice that the positive connection, which is responsible for the inflow of particles, was placed over Southern America when the anomalies appeared on the Ovation Monitor. Interesting readings can be seen at the same time on the plasma temperature monitor. But the same process took place a couple hours earlier. However, the temperature didn't grow that high over Northern Pole, as it did after. This event was much stronger. When you look at the electron cloud at 300 kilometers, you will see nicely as the connectivity point changes its location. At the same time, nitrogen oxide started to freak out over the Northern Pole. It was not a surprise for me that soon before the time of Schumann resonance impulse, particles from the current ring were again discharged. And this is magnetic reconnection with the low energy field. but the best readings can be seen on the new SWMF magnetopulse position monitor. Lack of particles in current ring allowed the flux tubes to connect to our planet in multiple areas. By accident, the time is matching perfectly. I think that such a big injection of particles from space is enough to explain this impulse. I've already added the Schumann Resonance Monitor on my website. It looks that we went through another sector boundary crossing a couple minutes after 8 UTC on June 27. Enlil satellite doesn't know anything about it. However, this event clearly affected the geomagnetic field. I really regret to announce you that you can't trust the NSO gong models, which show heliospheric field lines and coronal hole polarities. If you will look at the readings from last couple days, you should notice that NSO specialists apparently didn't notice a huge and dark coronal hole, which is currently directly facing Earth right now. According to this monitor, there are currently two coronal holes on the Earth-facing disk and both have positive polarity. We can see here as well that the positive pole moved over northern hemisphere, what should mean that the polarity reversal is complete. However, when we will look at different monitors, we will notice that the coronal hole in the middle has opposite polarity to the one on front. SDO images with the PFSS field lines overlay doesn't leave any doubts. Field lines are connecting both coronal holes, so they need to have opposite polarity. But this is not all. If you look at the northern hemisphere, you will notice that the positive corona hole is connected as well with the field where, according to NSO, supposed to be placed the main positive polarity of the Sun. The conclusion is short. Positive pole of the entire heliosphere is still not over the North Pole, and people from NSO are totally wrong. This is how I will draw the heliospheric polarity if my opinion would have any value to real scientists. And what a surprise! It seems that my opinion in this case is really close to the latest readings made by scientists from Lockheed Martin. But according to their monitors, negative polarity covers much bigger area. But let's compare the ecliptic view from Gong to the one from Lockheed Martin. Positive polarity is visible on Gong in green color. On LMSAL page, positive field lines are the white ones. It seems that those two readings are in complete opposition to each other. However, because LMSAL monitors work with SDO images much better, I will forget about NSO for some time. Not so long ago, I recorded how the polarity of coronal hole flipped from positive to negative polarity. It seems that suddenly the positive field lines simply disappeared just when they started to point towards Earth, and appeared again when the coronal hole moved further from the middle of Earth-facing disk. Right now, our planet should be facing the negative field on the surface of the Sun. Synoptic map from Stanford site confirms it. However, there is one main problem. The connection Sun-Earth doesn't form a straight line, and because of Parker's spiral, the connectivity point is shifted most of the time to the direction in which Sun is rotating. So, even if right now the Sun is facing us directly with negative coronal hole, if we want to learn the polarity of IMF's sector in which Earth is placed at the moment, we need to look at the direction of heliospheric field lines at the point where we are connected to our star. And on this image, we can see that the main connectivity point is placed on the region where the polarity is positive. That's why, according to ANIL nowcast monitors, Earth is currently placed in positive IMF sector. The only problem is that when we look at more simple version of this monitor, we will notice that here the polarity of IMF is reversed. I have no idea why. Anyway, at the same time, when on the Lockheed Martin readings, the coronal hole switched its polarity, ENLIL generated some very interesting images. Before the polarity of coronal hole flipped, Air Force placed in the negative part of IMF. On the middle screen, we can see that the heliospheric current sheet was placed above our planet. But in the morning, 26th of June, everything changed. It looks that during those couple hours there was a great shift of the heliospheric current flow. Some kind of force pushed the current sheet of the heliosphere towards the sun, and for a short time Earth was placed in the negative part of IMF. If you will check the images of Sun from that period of time, you will notice that quite a lot of different monitors is missing frames. Probably this process was pretty violent, and we were simply spared from watching such disturbing readings. To finish nicely the subject of heliosphere, I will show you some graphs which show the strength of Sun magnetic field from 1976 till today. The closer to zero the line is placed, the weaker the heliosphere is. Those two graphs show the strength of northern and southern poles. Notice that all the time before, both poles were changing their polarity. Each such shift was connected with natural solar cycle. However, you should be able to notice something already. It looks that with each next cycle, the strength of heliosphere was smaller than before. Currently, both poles are oscillating around zero, what didn't happen before. Since 1976, the strength of heliosphere was never such low. If you still don't believe that Sun is rapidly losing strength of its magnetic field, just look at those plots. If this trend won't change really soon, entire solar system can be in big trouble. For the end, something for those who believe that just by looking at the GOES satellite environment graphs, they are capable to say what is the condition of entire magnetosphere. You know who I'm talking about, don't you? My advice is simple. If you want to discuss the condition of magnetosphere, just look at monitors which actually show the magnetosphere. Using just the GOES readings from SWPC to talk about our magnetic field is like trying to tell about Da Vinci's Mona Lisa in binary code. Next time, when you will hear some guy telling that the magnetosphere is doing just fine without any proofs of such claim, simply go to ISWA, enter the 13th page in Magnetosphere tab, and run 2nd, 3rd and 4th monitor. They don't have thumbnails. Because it is very possible that after running the animation you will learn that the magnetosphere is not doing just fine. Actually you might feel a little bit uneasy, because some of those images can be quite disturbing. Okay, that's it for today. Class dismissed. Peace.